Well, good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us today. I'd like to begin with a special word of thanks to our Ford and Lincoln Mercury dealers, also to all of the men and women at the Chicago Assembly and Stamping Plant, as well as the Supplier Park. The products built here in Chicago, the Ford 500, the Mercury Montego, and the Ford Freestyle, have been the foundation of some pretty big success stories for our company. First, Ford's 29% increase in crossover sales in 2005 was double the industry average. And a big reason why that happened was Chicago's own Ford Freestyle. Now, on the car side of the business, the Ford 500 and the Mercury Montego helped us achieve our first full year increase in car share since 1999. Now, I think that's a pretty good start, but it's only a start. As you know, we have committed to stabilize Ford's overall market share in the near term and restore profitability in North America no later than 2008. And we're going to do it by driving American innovation into every aspect of our business. That includes technology to help our customers save money at the pump and reduce America's dependence on foreign oil. Now, as the President said in the State of the Union address, our country is committed to build better batteries for hybrid vehicles, pollution-free cars that run on hydrogen, and to step up ethanol as an alternative fuel to gasoline. And we at Ford are leading the way. Now, Ford developed the first hybrid SUV, and we have two hybrids on the road today, the Ford Escape and the Mercury Mariner. And we're stepping up our hybrid offerings dramatically in the years ahead. We're also continuing to develop and refine our hydrogen fuel cell technology. And today we're announcing a dramatic next step in our partnership with VeriSun Energy to build E85 refueling stations. Now, by the end of this year, Ford and VeriSun will work with fuel providers and state officials to develop the Midwest Ethanol Corridor. We plan to add approximately 20 new E85 outlets in Illinois and Missouri this year. That's a 30% increase, which will bring the number of public E85 refueling stations to about 120 in Illinois, 47 in Missouri, and more than 500 nationwide. The potential of E85 is huge. Just consider the impact in the state of Illinois alone. Corn grown in Illinois is used to produce about 40% of the country's ethanol. The Illinois Corn Growers Association says investment by the ethanol industry in Illinois already exceeds $1 billion, and it's also creating thousands of jobs. For the nation, ethanol helps reduce our dependence on foreign oil, and global warming with less carbon dioxide released into the atmosphere than conventional gasoline. Now, we at Ford Motor Company believe the country is only beginning to scratch the surface of ethanol's potential for our economy. Ford has a long history with ethanol, going back to the first car of Henry Ford. And for the last decade, Ford has produced flexible fuel vehicles that can run on E85. And we now have more than 1.6 million ethanol-powered vehicles on the road, including 50,000 right here in the state of Illinois. That number is going to grow quickly because the first Ford F-150 that uses E85 are arriving in dealerships even as we speak. So please be sure to check it out today, the pretty little green truck over there. And we're looking beyond that, and we're searching for new innovations for ethanol. Here's one example. the new Ford Escape Hybrid E85 research vehicle. This is the world's first hybrid that is capable of operating on E85 ethanol. Just consider the fact, if only 5% of US vehicles were powered by hybrids using E85, oil imports could be reduced by 140 million barrels a year. Now that's no drop in the bucket. We believe ethanol hybrids together are a winning combination, and you'll see this kind of American innovation only from Ford Motor Company. Now we're going to keep innovating on hybrids and ethanol because it fits perfectly with our mission to be America's car company. We're also working to help drive American innovation within the communities we serve. And that includes putting more hybrids right here on the streets of Chicago. To tell you more about it, it is my pleasure to introduce Cisco Cadino, Ford's new Group Vice President of North America, Marketing, Sales, and Service. Cisco?
Well, Ann, thank you very much, and it's a pleasure to be here with you in Chicago, with all of you. Now, before I get into some great news about hybrid vehicles, I'd like to touch on some of the other successes we're having. As many of you know, we just capped up our 29th consecutive year of truck leadership, and we're off to a fast start this year. F-Series sales were up 7% in January, and our share of the segment is up 3.5 points. Yes, you don't often see that kind of stories. Nor do you see that GM, Dodge, and Nissan all posted share declines in January. Our new Fusion is selling equally well. Fusion sales have improved every month since we introduced it in the fall. In January, Fusion sales were up 32% compared with December. And our share of the segment is climbing dramatically. While the Toyota Camry, Honda Accord, Chevy Malibu, and the Nissan Altima all posted share declines. Now, these two products, the F-Series and the Fusion, and the share gains that we're making, gives us the confidence about delivering on our promise to stabilize our share in the near term and grow over time. We're equally bullish about growing the market for the hybrid vehicles, particularly here in Chicago. We applaud the joint industry government cooperation that's helping us to put hybrids in more customers' hands. Last month, Illinois Governor Rod Blagojevich proposed a $500 sales tax rebate for customers who buy vehicles like the Ford Escape or Mercury Marinette Hybrid that would be on top of the new federal hybrid tax credits. In addition, last week, Travel Insurance began offering a 10% discount on hybrid drivers. And today, the Chicago City Council is considering a new ordinance that will bring more than 120 hybrid taxi cabs to Chicago streets beginning next year. Now, that's roughly about one hybrid for every 50 taxis in the city. Ford Motor Company applauds and heartily endorses these types of initiatives, because it will make people's lives better by saving gas, keeping more money in their pockets, and reducing pollution. The taxi initiative is a dramatic and bold step, and Ford is proud to be leading the way. We're already working with New York and San Francisco to put Escape Hybrid taxis into service, and the feedback has been tremendous. Many of these vehicles in our San Francisco fleet now have more than 100,000 miles on them. And some of the drivers say they're saving between $50 to $75 every week by driving an Escape Hybrid. In New York, the Taxi and Limousine Commission officials estimate annual fuel savings will amount to thousands of dollars for every driver. And here in Chicago, we're working hard to ensure the first hybrid taxis you see at O'Hare Airport, at Metro stations, on the Magnificent Mile will be from Ford. We look forward to working with the city and taxi operators to make it happen. In fact, we would like to offer an escape hybrid to the city today to educate drivers and the public about hybrid vehicles. We think it will build a lot of excitement. Mayor Daley shares our enthusiasm, and he sends this message from today's council meeting, and I quote, "Our new taxi cab ordinance encourages cab drivers to add hybrid vehicles, which conserve energy, save money, and help the environment. Ford has been an important part of the Chicago economy for many years, and I welcome their participation in this program. Now, to accept the keys to the first hybrid on behalf of the city, Sadu Johnston, Commissioner, Chicago Department of Environment, is here to accept that. Sadu, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mayor Daley, City Council Commission Johnston, we thank you for all your efforts. Together, we will find out, in fact, that it is easy being green. And we've taken that message to consumers as millions of Americans saw on Sundays during the Super Bowl. Let's take another look at that.
It's not that easy being green. Having to spend each day the color of the leaves. When I think it could be nicer being red or yellow or gold. It's not that easy being green. I guess it is easy being green.
The 36 mile per gallon Ford Escape Hybrid.
Whoop. Oh, hi there, folks. By the way, I did my own stunts in that thing. It wasn't easy for a frog. How's everybody? Quiet. I understand. It's all right. It's a group of people. Hey, listen, folks. I am Kermit the Frog, and I want to thank you all very much for being here. Here I am, the frog with no shoulders in the city of big shoulders. It's an honor to be here at the Chicago Auto Show with all you folks. You know, I have to tell you, usually when a frog is around this many cars, we get sort of a rundown feeling. But I'm quite happy to be here myself. And I'm especially proud to be here representing Ford. They brought me up here. And the new Ford Escape Hybrid, which I'm lucky enough to be sitting on top of. I can tell you it's very slippery and cold. I don't think that has anything to do with selling cars, though. I just wanted to say, you know, when you're dating a pig, it's definitely important to be driving a car called Escape. That's a pretty big deal. But even more than that, the hybrid is great for the environment. You know, it uses less gas, it goes more miles. It actually makes it easier being green for all of us. So on behalf of myself and the amphibian Americans everywhere, I want to say thank you very much. And thank you all for coming. I believe that's probably the end of our presentation here.
Ho, ho, ho.
Oh, it's Majic Johnson.
Hold on.
Oh, it's Majic Johnson. Oh, how are you, sir?
Everything's good. How you doing, Kermit?
I'm hanging in there. You know, are you still up for a little one-on-one later?
Now, wait a minute.
Yeah?
I played against Larry Bird, Michael Jordan.
Yeah?
You think that you can handle me one-on-one?
Oh, listen, I'll bring my game, you know? Wait till you see my super mini Skyhook. It's off the hizzle.
Well, you're going to have to bring your A game if you're going to mess with me one-on-one.
Okay, okay. You mean that was Larry Bird you played? I thought it was Big Bird. Sorry. Sorry, maybe I'm mistaken. I don't know. Well, listen, why are you here?
Well, I'm here to really share some really big news about Lincoln today.
Oh, cool.
And I'm going to share it with all these great folks out here.
Well, that's great. That's great. That's good. So listen, I'm going to go get into my sweats and maybe a pair of stilts.
You do that, all right.
And I'll see you a little later.
You got it. You got it.
Hey, thanks, everybody. Majic Johnson.
Yes.
Wow.
It's really great to be here in Chicago this afternoon. Normally, I'm sharing elbows with Michael Jordan, and unfortunately, we came up on a short end of the stick most of the time playing the Bulls. But, somebody's clapping? Man. But we're not going to talk about that. I'm here to really share with you some great things that Lincoln is doing. I've been in partnership with Lincoln for about 4 years now, and especially with the Magic Johnson Foundation. We have over 225 minority students on scholarship, and Lincoln has showed everybody that they're a company with a heart and a soul, and that you can do business, great business, as well as give back at the same time. So I want to thank Lincoln for helping those who have the grades to get into college, but just don't have the financial means. So can we give Lincoln a hand for doing just that? Lincoln is just like myself about class and style. And today we're here to show you the 2007 Navigator, which is the first original SUV, as well as the 2007 Navigator L, which, you know, a big man like me needs a lot more size and room. So if we can now display that for the folks, please. And just to show you, I haven't lost my touch as far as the basketball is concerned. I want to no-look a couple of balls out there, and hopefully the people can catch them. Couple more. Okay. How about one more? All right. So to let you know about these great new SUVs, the Navigator and Navigator L, I'm going to bring Peter to the stage, and he can tell you more about both of these great and new exciting SUVs. Peter, come on up, please. Let's give Peter a hand.
Well, thank you, Majic. Wow. You know, I have to say, it's not easy following a world-famous frog and one of the greatest basketball players of all time. But fortunately, I do have these two very powerful Lincolns to help me out. Now, the new Lincoln Navigator offers really an uncompromising level of luxury, capability, functionality, and attitude. Do I say that right in English? Attitude? The dramatic and distinctive design conveys both the confidence and power, beginning with the chrome grille, with both vertical and horizontal bars inspired by that Lincoln star right in the middle. Tall chamfers define the power dome hood, and clean, sheer surface distinguishes the Navigator's new profile. Under the hood, the Navigator is powerful as well, with an advanced 300 horsepower, 5.4-liter, three-valve Triton V8, mated to a six-speed automatic transmission. And this Navigator delivers its strong performance on regular gasoline, not the premium brands that our competition recommends, and an all-new independent rear suspension system that further refines the ride and handling. Now, inside, we're setting new standards of comfort, craftsmanship, quietness, and convenience. The flow-through center console, the elegance of dark ebony or light wood, and the satin nickel and chrome accents. And premium leather adds to the very high level of comfort in all three rows. And we've added more legroom for the first and third rows. Plus, Navigator offers state-of-the-art entertainment and navigation system. Now, its bigger brother, the Navigator L, is all that and more. 14.7 inches more, to be precise. And as Majic said, the L comes standard with an additional 25 feet, actually, of extra cargo volume behind the third row seat. Now, both of these Navigators beautifully combine the style, luxury, comfort, and functionality. And that makes the Navigator unique in its class. But Navigator isn't the only news we have today. The Lincoln Zephyr, which debuted to strong sales last fall, will be reborn for the 2007 model year as a sportier, more distinctive, and more powerful car with a new 250 horsepower, 3.5 liter V6 engine, a newly designed front, available all-wheel drive, and an alternative of satin nickel trim inside. And all of that with a new name, the Lincoln Mark Z. Now, customers love this sedan. They say it's sure-footed, sporting, and that's why it's drawing a new generation of customer to the Lincoln brand. So if you look at the product announcements we made in the last month, the Lincoln Mark X crossover, the Mark S full-size luxury sedan teaser, and now the Navigator and the updated Mark Z, you're seeing still more momentum for the Lincoln brand, a unique blend of elegant American design, performance, and comfort. That is Lincoln. And with that, I'd like to invite Anne and Cisco back onto the stage, and I hope you will join us in a few minutes to take a closer look at these important new Lincolns. Thank you so much.